Earlier this week, Tucker Carlson said one of the craziest things he's ever said. I know that's hard. He works every week to say crazier and crazier things. But this week he said that the COVID vaccine, quote, doesn't work and they're simply not telling you that. Sorry, he asked questions with a really dumb look on his face. He didn't actually say it, he just said it over and over and over again. Because he can't find out how effective it is. How would you do that? You'd have to have the internet or bookers. And he doesn't have either of those things. Well, we decided to do a bit of work. And we found out, according to the CDC, only 0.008% of the fully vaccinated population has been infected with the coronavirus 2 weeks after their final dose. So once you've received a full dose, what are your odds of getting it? Well, so far, very low. Out of more than 66 million Americans who've been fully vaccinated, there have been about 5,800 cases of COVID-19 that have actually been identified after that. Of these, what they're called breakthrough cases, more than 40% occurred in people older than 60. So still, the older are more likely to be affected. 65% of the cases were in female patients. I wonder if they're controlling for how likely they are to get it though, because I know men are less likely to get the vaccine. So bear that in mind. The CDC found that 29% of breakthrough infections were asymptomatic. So even like it's even less than 0.008 because you're gonna have a very mild case potentially. Only 74 people have died after experiencing breakthrough infections. So that is damn near 1 in a million right there, Ben. But sorry, I don't know why I'm telling you this. Tucker's the one who apparently needs to know.
Yeah, no, it's amazing. The amount of disinformation, misinformation, propaganda, and gaslighting that Tucker Carlson is paid about $8 million a year to spew. And how damaging it is to the actual lives of people. I mean, he was part of the entire Fox cabal that downplayed the virus in the first place, leading to, I think they actually had a study showing that Fox News viewers were more prone to get the virus because of the misinformation. Yeah. And yet and still, you know, he's spewing all this racist, white supremacist, white replacement theory garbage. And in the height of all the things that are going on with the pandemic and the George Floyd protest and the Derek Chauvin trial and the Dante Wright protest, all that's going on, you can regularly see Tucker Carlson just in your timeline on television, just making it worse over and over again. I don't really know what to say except for he is the main character, main villain in terms of the media presence because he is doing the most damage I think anybody I've seen on media in my lifetime.
I think he's far and away the worst. Like Trump is releasing statements telling people to get the vaccine.
Yeah.
Ivanka Trump just got it and put it on Instagram. Like he is by far the worst. And what makes it even worse is partially that he has so many viewers, partially that he has the last vestiges of this insane, totally media created idea that he's reasonable in some way, that he's not Sean Hannity when he's far worse than Sean Hannity or Laura Ingraham. It's also that you might recall, and I think this is the study that you're referring to, very early on in the pandemic, like a month in, they released this study showing that people who watched Sean Hannity were more likely to get sick and die than people who watched Tucker Carlson. They gave Tucker Carlson credit. And the reason they could do that is because Tucker Carlson, as bad as it would be if he was totally anti-mask and vaccine his whole life, if he was consistently awful, he wasn't. The first few weeks of the pandemic, he didn't yet know where the political winds were. Maybe Trump is gonna take this super seriously. So I'm gonna take it seriously. We're gonna crush this thing. He's gonna protect America and get reelected. Oh no, he's not gonna do that? Oh, well then masks are the worst thing. Social distancing is the worst thing. Caring about your fellow man, that's actually weakness. Don't do that. And so after a couple of weeks of relatively taking it seriously compared to other Fox hosts, he then suddenly was worse than all of them. More anti-mask, more anti-lockdown, more anti-social distancing, and now by far the worst when it comes to the vaccine.
Yeah, you know, I can't for the life of me. I don't have a price tag. John, I know you don't have a price tag. I mean, we obviously could go and make obscene amounts of money if we just get red-pilled all of a sudden. Mm-hmm. But the price tag for Tucker selling his soul, I mean, it there he is, and he's doing it to the detriment of so many lives. People are dying because of this misinformation, and yet he's paid a fortune to spew it.
Exactly, 100%. He's getting rich, mediocre and comfortable, and also rich. That is who runs this country. It's politics, it's companies, and it's media.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.